स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बो मुद्रितोः प्रपन्नार्तिक्षिदो नखाः विवक्षा तत्परत्वेन नाङ्गित्वेन कदाचन काले च ग्रहणत्यागौ नातिनिर्वहणैषिता निर्व्यूढावपि च अङ्गत्वे यत्नेन प्रत्यवेक्षणं रूपकादिरलङ्कारवर्गस्य अङ्गत्वसाधनं सो दिस् इस् द टापिक् दट् वि आर् डीलिङ्ग् वित् वि लुक्ड् एट् विवक्षा तत्परत्वेन अण्ड् काले च ग्रहणं नौ वि हाव् टु लुक् एट् काले च त्यागः ओ इल्ल काले ग्रहणं वि हव् नाट् सीन् नो वि डिड् दट् दट् इस् उद्दामोत्कलिकां इल्ल we looked at uddamotkalikam which is avasare grahanam grihitihi yata now it is grihitam apicha yam avasare tad rasa anugunataya alankarantara apekshaya yatha so tyajati yam avasare tyajati so grihitam api alankaram yam avasare tyajati at the correct moment you will have to let go of an alankara also you should not keep holding on until the end that is na ati nirvahana ishita ati nirvahanam api na kartavyam at the same time you will have to drop it whenever it is not necessary and if there is an alankara another alankara that is suitable then you will have to bring it in at the appropriate time this is something so it could be very abstract to think about but only with examples we can understand how it works raktastvam navapallavaihi ahamapi shlaghyaihi priyaya gunaihi twamayanti shili mukhaah smaradhanur muktas tatha mamapi kaanta pada talahati tavamude tadvan mamapi avayoho sarvam tulyam ashoka kevalamaham dhatra sashoka krutah atrahi प्रबन्धप्रवृत्तः अपि श्लेषः व्यतिरेकविवक्षया त्यज्यमानः रसविशेषं पुष्णाति श्लेष मीन्स् इन्वाल्व्स् टु मीनिङ्ग्स् फार् वन् वर्ड् वेदर् द वर्ड् केन् बि चेञ्ज्ड् आर् नाट् आर् वेदर् इफ् द वर्ड् केन् बि चेञ्ज्ड् देन् इट् इस् अर्थश्लेषं सो द डबल् मीनिङ्ग् इस् बेस्ड् आन् ओन्ली द अर्थं दट् इस् देर् इफ् द वर्ड् इस् चेञ्ज्ड् देन् द श्लेष इट् सेल्फ् इस् नाट् देर् if shabdaparivritti asahatvam chet tatra shabdashlesha shabdaparivritti sahatvam asti chet arthashlesha so there are two types of shlesha and in this shlokam he gives examples for both shlesha shabdashlesha and arthashlesha then another alankaram that is also there in this is vyatireka alankarah where there is a difference is being shown between the upamana and the upameya someone is comparing himself to an ashoka tree and saying that you know the ashoka tree everything is equal between the two of us but there is just one problem I have been created with grief you are not so the word ashoka is yasya shokah na vidyate one who does not have any sorrow parantu aham sashoka krita so here it is a virahi a person who is separated from his lover is addressing the ashoka tree and he is talking He is saying, Tvam navapallavaihi raktaha. You are raktaha. You are red in color. It is a rakta ashoka tree. So you are red in color because of new leaves that have come about and that is contributing to the redness in you. So raktaha tvam navapallavaihi ahamapi raktaha katham priyayaha shlagyaihi gunaihi. Priyayaha, my beloved has so many praiseworthy qualities. Shlagyaihi gunaihi, shlaghitum yogya. गुणाः तैः अहमपि तस्याम् अनुरक्तः अस्मि देर् द रक्त द वर्ड् इस् नाट् अ रेड् कलर् बट् अनुरक्तः अनुरागयुक्तः अस्मि सो अहमपि अनुरक्तः श्लाघ्यैः प्रियायाः गुणैः नौ वाट् इस् द नेक्स्ट् सिमिलारिटि दट् इस् सेयिङ्ग् त्वाम् आयान्ति शिलीमुखाः शिलीमुखाः बीस् So here, raktaha cannot be changed into shonitaha. Shonitaha will not give you the meaning of anuraktaha, anuraga yuktaha. I can't say priyaha. If I have to say aham priyayaha gunaihi hritaha, I can't say hritaha. Then that hritaha I am attracted cannot occur for Ashoka tree. So I cannot change the word raktaha to any of its synonym. So it is a shabdashlesha there. ओके सो त्वं नवपल्लवैः रक्तः अहमपि श्लाघ्यैः प्रियायाः श्लाघ्यैः गुणैः रक्तः एव अनुरक्तः त्वामायान्ति शिलीमुखाः द सेम् वित् शिलीमुख आल्सो शिलीमुख मीन्स् बोत् भ्रमराः तथा बाणाः अपि मन्मथस् एरोस् आर् आल्सो शिलीमुख भ्रमर आर् बीज् आर् आल्सो काल्ड् शिलीमुख सो शिलीमुखाः बीज् अप्रोच् यु त्वाम् आयान्ति बिकास् यु हेव् फ्लवर्स् एण्ड् द बीज् आर् अट्राक्टेड् टुवर्ड्स् द फ्लवर्स् एण्ड् दि कम् टुवर्ड्स् यु तथा इन् द सेम् मेनर् मामपि शिलीमुखाः आयान्ति कीदृशाः शिलीमुखाः स्मरधनुर्मुक्ताः मन्मथ धनुषः आगताः निर्गताः शिलीमुखाः बाणाः माम् आयान्ति सो मन्मथस् एफेक्ट् इस् देर् आन् मी एण्ड् ही इस् throwing his arrows on me. So the arrows that come from Manmatha's bows are approaching me. So we both are the same that way. Shili mukaha twamapi ayanti, mamapi ayanti. Kevalam tatra twam brahmaraha papnuvanti parantu mam bhanaha. Next one is kanta padatala ahati tava padatala ahatihi tava mude tadvatu mamapi. Mamapi kanta padatala ahatihi मुदे एव मम मुदे एव सो मुद मुत् सन्तोषः सो तव सन्तोषाय कान्तायाः पाद आहतिः भवति दोहदविषये सो वेन् अ लेडी नो वेन् अ ट्री इस् नाट् ब्लूमिङ्ग् सो अ लेडी ड्रेप् अलङ्क शी शी डेकरेट्स् हर् फुट् एण्ड् शी किक्स् द ट्री which makes it very ashamed and so it blossoms forth. This is in Kavi Samayam. This is something that has been accepted in the poetry world. So, Kanta Pada Tala Ahatihi Dohadam. Ahati means hitting or kicking, but you take it as Kanta Dohadam. So, a Dohada Kriya which has been performed by the lady is for your happiness. So, when a tree bursts into flowers, it is like it is showing its happiness in the form of flowers. So, tava mude, it is for your happiness. In the same way, if my beloved's foot touches me, kanta padatala ahatihi, ratikeli samaye, athava surata samaye, when we both are joining together, at that point, if her foot hits me in that process, then that is for me a happiness only, because I'm enjoying that sport with her. Tadvat, mama api, तस्याः पादतल आहतिः हियर् ऐ केन् चेञ्ज् कान्ता टु ललना आहति टु वाट् एवर् प्रहारः एनी अदर् वर्ड् ऐ केन् चेञ्ज् इट् टु सो शब्दपरिवृत्ति सहत्वमस्ति अत्र तस्मात् अर्थश्लेषः ईस् एक्स्प्लेन्ड् बोत् टैप् आफ़् श्लेष इन् दिस् श्लोकम् सो कान्तापादतल आहतिः ममापि एवम् In these three stanzas, in these three lines, we see avayoho sarvam tulyam. Hey Ashoka, we both are equal in all of these aspects. Kevalam aham dhatra sashoka krutaha. I am not able to enjoy this scene with her. So tas taya virahitaha aham sashokaha krutaha. This is in, I think, Vikramorushiyam. I'm not sure. Vikramorushiyam danne ama it doesn't say anything but it is a enama
ile per vandu idu hanuman natakathla podra anda attana koot enna solradhu kootama ella shlokathiyum podra
okay so this is also hanuman natakam na it is sitaya virahitah iti so we have to take it like that or urvashi virahitah so I don't know it's a popular shlokam and hanuman natakam is also it takes a lot of other shlokas also it is not idilla it's not created by it is also a compilation of many other shlokas so atrahi prabandha pravrittah api sleshah now you have slesha in the first three stanzas sleshah vyatireka vivakshaya in order to say that vyatireka the difference between ashoka and sashoka the vakta वक्ता सशोकः अस्ति शोकेन सहितः अस्ति किन्तु अशोकः शोकरहितः इति अन्वर्थनाम तस्य सो व्यतिरेकविवक्षया इन् आर्डर् टु वेन् यु हैलैट् दट् व्यतिरेकम् इट् इण्टेन्सिफैस् द विप्रणम्बशृङ्गार दट् इस् देर् सि यु बोत् आफ़् अस् आर् ईक्वल् but you have been created as Ashoka. Yasya Shokaha Nasti. But I have been created with Shoka. That is, I am separated from my wife and I'm suffering. So that Vyatireka Alankara actually heightens the Vipralambashrungara more than the Slesha. So if he had continued with the Slesha even in the last one, it may not have paved the way for Vipralambashrungara. So Prabandha Pravrittaha Api Sleshaha, even though the verse starts with the Pravrittaha means Arambaha. So when the verse starts with the Slesha, Vyatireka Vivakshaya, in order to give that Vyatirekam, Tyajyamanaha, Kaha Tyajyamanaha, Slesha Alankaraha Tyajyamanaha Asti, Tasmat Rasa Vishesham Pushnati, Rasa Vishesham Vipralambashrungaram Pushnati. It heightens the Vipralambashrungara and the Vyatireka becomes more suited for the Vipralambashrungara. So he drops the Shlesha like a hot cake and then moves on to another Alankara. So Kale Tyagaha is also important. Now, as an example for Kale Tyagaha, this has been given by Anandavardhana and it fits perfectly. We understand what that is. Now, in this particular slokam, if you look at it, there is Shlesha Alankara and Vyatireka Alankara. Anandavardhana goes on a tangent from here for the next paragraph and including two shlokas. That is for the next paragraph and No Kalpapaya Vayo and Akrandaha Stanitaihi, both of these shlokas. This is a small discussion on what is this, whether it is a Sankara Alankara in this shlokam or whether it is a Samsrishti Alankara or is it a totally different Alankara, a new Alankaram called Sleshavyatireka Alankara. So what is the status of the Alankaras in this particular shloka? So that he moves on a tangent with that discussion over the next two shlokas and then comes back to the original thing of Kale cha grahana tyagau nati nirvahana aishita. So now we are in Kale tyagaha and there is a slight separate discussion of whether it is Sankara Alankara or Samsrishti Alankara here. Now before we get into that discussion, let's look at what is Sankara and what is Samsrishti. I have taken the definition of Prataparudriyam because it's the easiest to understand without any complications. Tilatandula samslesha nyayate yatra parasparam samslishyeyuhu alankaraha sa samsrishtihi nigadhyate. Yatra yasmin shloke artha alankaraha, whether it is shabdalankara or arthalankara. Now prakrite tu arthalankaranam eva vivachanam asti. So we will take only arthalankaras. Where the arthalankaras samslishya tila tandula nyayam. Tilam is sesame seed, tandula is rice grains. When you mix rice grains and sesame, one is white and one is black. Sesames are black. This is not polished sesame seeds, which is also white. No, we are looking at black tilam and white tandulam. So you know that those two are separate and you can separate them also. So if alankaras are present in a shlokam where it is not interdependent and they can be separated from each other, that is samsrishti alankara. Whereas Sankara, kshiraniranayadyatra, sambandaha syat parasparam, alankriti nametasam, sankaraha saudahritaha. Kshiraniranyayena, when you pour water into milk or milk into water, you cannot separate the two. Which means either they both are dependent on each other or the level of which is dependent on the other is sandeham. Or one word, the entire alankara may be dependent on one word. So there are three types of that Sankara Alankara. We need not go into the further classifications of Sankara Alankara. For the present context, we only need to know what the definition is, which is Kshiraniranayat. Etasam Alankritinam. When all of these Alankaras are mixed together in a manner that you cannot separate them and view, then it is Sankara Alankara. Now there is the next passage is arranged in a Shanka and Apurupakshi and Siddhanti manner. There is a question and the Siddhanti answers. That's how it is and I've just separated it out like this. ஃபார் ஈஸியர் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங். சோ ந அத்ர ந அத்ர அலங்காரத்வய சன்னிபாதஹ கிந்தர்ஹி அலங்காராந்தரமேவ ஸ்லேஷவ்யதிரேக லக்ஷணம் நரசிம்ஹவத் இதி சேத் ந. தட் இஸ் யுவர் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் போர்ஷன். நவ் ஹவு டு யூ ரீட் தட், ஹவு டு யூ செபரேட் இட்? ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ந அத்ர அலங்காரத்வய சன்னிபாதஹ. அத்ர இத்யுக்தே ரக்தஸ்த்வம் இத்யத்ர. சோ ஹியர் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் த்ரீ லைன்ஸ் யூ ஹாவ் ஸ்லேஷ அண்ட் தென் யூ ஹாவ் வியதிரேக அலங்காரம், ரைட்? சோ அத்ர ரக்தஸ்த்வம் இதி ஸ்லோகே அலங்காரத்வய சன்னிபாதஹ இதி ந கிம் தர்ஹி. இட் இஸ் நாட், சி, டூ அலங்காராஸ் ஆர் நாட் தேர். த பூர்வபக்ஷி, திஸ் இஸ் நாட் ஆனந்த வர்தனா ஆர் அபினவ் குப்தாஸ் ஸ்டாண்ட் பாயிண்ட். சோ அத்ர அலங்காரத்வய சன்னிபாதஹ ந கிம் தர்ஹி, வாட் இஸ் இட் தென்? The Purupakshi says, Alankarantarameva. It is a completely different Alankara that he is talking about. Slesha Vyatireka Lakshanam. Narasimhavati. Narasimhavati. See, it is Manushya Simhayoho Yatha Sankaraha Bhavati Tatha Narasimhaha Iti Sanya Bhavati Tatha Atrapi Slesha Vyatirekaha Iti Alankara Dvayasya Sambhave. It is not two separate Alankaras. They both are mixed together in a manner. See, Narasimha, you cannot remove the Simha part and remove the Nara part and appreciate two differently. Then it becomes gross. You look at it as one form with two parts. That's all. In the same manner, here also, it is a totally different Alankara called Aslesha Vyatireka. There are 350 Alankaras that people have said. Why not we have a separate Alankara called Slesha Vyatireka? See, the problem with that is Anantyam. Then I can have Upama Utpreksha, Utpreksha Rupakam, Rupaka Apannuti. So many, there are actually Rupaka Apannuti and all is a type of Alankara itself. But here, why don't we have something called Slesha Vyatireka Alankara? Siddhanti iti chet na. So that's how you separate the entire line and understand who has said what. Iti chet na. Tasya prakarantarena vyavasthapanat. Tasya means lesha vyatireka sankarasya. Prakarantarena vyavasthapanat. In this particular shloka raktastvam, there is lesha alankara in the first three, and then there is Vyatireka Alankara in the fourth line. It is not dependent on each other. The Vyatireka is separate from the Slesha Alankara. If we have to view it as Narasimha, then both should be interdependent. He's going to give an example of that. Slesha, Vyatireka, and he also says Sarvam Tulyam Ashoka. Tulyam means Upama is there. So it is actually Slesha Upama. Slesha Upama and Vyatireka, there is a, if we have to have a Sankara, interdependency between those two, then Prakarantarena Vyavasthapanat, Anyamargena Vyavasthapayati Kavihi, Natu Evam, Raktastvam Ityatra Yatha Asti Tathana. We will use some other methodology to give an example for how Slesha and Vyatireka are codependent and it is a Sankara Alankara. How does he answer that? Further, yatra hi slesha vishaye eva shabde prakarantarena vyatireka pratitihi jayate saha tasya vishayah. So yatra hi yasmin shloke slesha vishaye eva shabde, when the words have slesha, that is double meaning, prakarantarena, in another, he uses a different method, and vyatirekaha pratiyate, and vyatireka alankara is also seen. Just giving this line, you're not going to understand. Only with the example, that line will again be more clear. Tasya vishayaha, saha tasya vishayaha, saha sankara vishayaha, slesha vyatireka sankarasya vishayaha asti. Katham yatha, saharihi namna devaha, Saharihi Varaturaga Nivahena. So this one is Saharihi. Harihi has many meanings here. Bhekaha, Ashwaha, Simhaha, Indraha, Vishnuhu. So many different meanings. So Harihi Saha Namna Devaha. that Hari or Indra or Vishnu is only Hari by name. He is a god just by name, Hari. Hari, Saharihi iti, if you combine those two words, instead of taking it as Saha Harihi Namna Devaha, instead of that, if you just combine in a sandhi, the visargam, visarga lobaha bhavati, tasmat saharihi iti uktam. If because of that visarga lopa, if you take it as just one combined word and say saharihi, the samasam becomes haribihi saha. Hari is ashwa. So ashvaihi saha yaha vartate varaturaga nivahena. Because of exquisite hybrid bred horses, you have a huge cavalry in your army, and because of that saharihi, you are with horses. So this is in praise of a king. So he is addressing a kavi who is using chatu ukti, a twist of words, and he is addressing the king and saying saharihi tvam varaturaga nivahena saha namna eva kevalam harihi. Saharihi namna eva, it is only by name he is called Hari. Saha Harihi, kintu tvam varaturaga nivahena, because you have an entire cavalry of pure bred horses, you are called Sahari. So there, you are showing the difference between God and the king in front of you using Slesha. Okay, so the Slesha helps to give that difference in meaning. Whereas, there in Raktastvam, Atra Prakrita Shloke Tu, Raktastvam Navapallavaihi Ityatra, Sleshasya Vishayaha Anyaha Eva, Anyaya Eva Shabdaha Sleshasya Vishayaha Anyascha Vyatirekasya, because Slesha is there only in Raktaha, Shilimukaha and Kantavadatalahati, only these words. Whereas Vyatireka, the difference between the Upamana and the Upameya is shown with the word Ashokaha and Sashokaha. It does not depend on the Sleshas there. In fact, the Slesha only contributes to the Upama there. It does not even contribute to the Vidureka Alankara. You get the difference? So, Anyascha Vyatirekasya Vishayaha Yadicha Evam Vidhe Vishaye Alankarantaratva Kalpana Kriyate Tat Samsrittehe Vishaya Apahara Evasyat Yadicha. If in such examples, like Raktastvam Navapallavaihi, if we have to say that it is Alankarantaratva Kalpana, if we create an Alankara for every such example of Sankara Alankara, then there is no scope for Samsrishti. Samsrishtehe Vishaya Apaharaha Evasyat. Samsrishtehe Vishayaha means the scope. Wherever we have to apply Samsrishti. Tilatandula Nyayena Alankaranam Vidyama Alankaraha Vidyante Iti Karanathas Samsrishtihi Atra. We will never have such places at all. Everywhere, then we will have to say it is in Upama Apannuti Alankara, Upama Lalita Alankara, whatever. The imagine the permutation combination of the 300 alankaras, then there will be innumerable infinite number of alankaras that we have to come about with. You don't know what sort of a combination a poet might come up with 50 years later with two alankaras. So that is samsrishtehe vishaya apaharaha eva vati. To just bring all of those types of alankaras under one umbrella, we have samsrishti. We always think that Sankara is so important, but the importance of Samsrishti he is bringing out, highlighting in this so beautifully. Samsrishti is equally important. Now, when we are analyzing Kavyas, it gets a very stepmotherly treatment, you know, Samsrishti. It is Samsrishti, it is Samsrishti, because there are two Alankaras there. Fine. We generally don't highlight it, but that is where Anandavardhana's beauty lies in. You know, the way he gives importance and gives the difference between Sankara and Samsrishti, if we don't have Samsrishti, look at the problem that we are faced with. So, yadicha evam vidhe vishaye alankarantaratva kalpana kriyate tat samsrishtehe vishaya apaharaha eva syat. We will never have an area where there is Samsrishti. Shanka. Next is Slesha mukhenaiva atra vyatirekasya atmalabaha iti na ayam samsrishtehe vishayaha iti che na. व्यतिरेकस्य प्रकारान्तरेणापि दर्शनात्. नौ द नेक्स्ट् सेण्टेन्स् हौ डु यु स्प्लिट् इट्? द पूर्वपक्षी आस्क्स्, नो नो, अत्र इन् दिस् रक्तस्त्वम् इट् इस् नाट् संसृष्टि फार् व्यतिरेक आत्मला व्यतिरेकस्य आत्मलाभः कथं भवति? आत्मलाभाय श्लेषः अत्र उपयुज्यते. बिकास् ऐ हेव् यूस्ड् श्लेष एण्ड् सेड् यु नो अशोक, यु एण्ड् ऐ आर् ईक्वल्, त्वमपि रक्तः अहमपि रक्तः, त्वामपि शिलीमुखाः आयान्ति मामपि शिलीमुखाः आयान्ति, परन्तु त्वम् अशोकः अहं सशोकः. सि इट् इस् आक्चुलि काण्ट्रिब्यूटिङ्ग् टुवर्ड्स् द व्यतिरेकम्. That is the Purvapakshi's question here. Slesha mukhenaiva. Using the slesha, he starts off, and that atma labaha, vyatirekasya atma labaha eva bhavati. Tasmat atra na samsrishtehe vishayaha iti che na. Siddhanti refutes that and says, if sleshopama has to contribute towards vyatireka, there are other places for me to show you an example. This is not the place. Raktasvam is not the place for that. It is samsrishti alankara. Slesha exists independent of vyatireka. It does not depend on vyatireka. So he gives an example of where sleshopama is dependent or vyatirekasya prakarantarena api. See, vyatireka can be without the slesha also. The next example will be where vyatireka exists with upama but no slesha. He is giving us different types of examples to just highlight the importance of samsrishti here. So vyatirekasya vyatireka alankara can exist in a shloka prakarantarena api slesha upamam vina api tasya darshanat. The example he takes from Surya Shataka. No kalpabaya vayor adaya rayada अदय रय दलत् क्ष्माधरस्यापि शम्या गाढोद्गीर्णोज्ज्वलश्रीरहनि न रहिता नो तमः कज्जलेन प्राप्तोत्पत्तिः पतङ्गात् न पुनरुपगता मोषमुष्णत्वषः वः वर्तिः सैव अन्यरूपा सुखयतु निखिलद्वीपद्वीपस्य द्वीपदीपस्य दीप्तिः. वेरि टफ् श्लोकस् सूर्यशतकम्. इफ् यु केन् मेमरैज् एण्ड् रिसैट् इट् ऐ थिङ्क् इट्स् near to impossible. It's a very difficult task. It's not impossible, but the words are very, so much of a tongue twister. No kalpa apaya vayoho, kalpa apaya vayoho no shamya. So he's talking of the surya kiranam, the sun's light, which is mushna tvishaha, ushna tvishaha, ushna twit means rays, the one who has very hot rays, which is Suryaha. So ushnatvishaha suryasya deeptihi prakashaha vaha yushmakam sukhayatu, let it give you happiness. May the sun's rays give you happiness. How is that sun's rays? Nikhila dvipa deepasya anyarupa vartihi eva. I'm going from the behind because the first and all is like an adjective to the deepti. So nikiladvipa deepasya, nikiladvipa saptadvipa vasundhara. This bhumi is has seven dvipa. In all the seven islands that are there in the earth, it is this deepasya eka eva esha anya rupa vartihi iva bhasate suryasya deeptihi prakashaha. Giving it in Strilingam is a beauty. It's like Suryaha is in Pullinga and Deeptihi is in Strilingam. So there is a Naika Naika Bhava. So this Surya's Prakasha is like an Anya Rupa Vartihi. It is like a different type of wick. Varti means that wick which has that Prakasham. So Varti Yukta Asti Esha, which is capable of lighting the entire, every island. So let it bring you joy. Sukhayatu. Kidrisha deeptihi. Ya deeptihi. Kalpa apaya vayoho api na shamya. It cannot be blown away. If you take a normal deepam, it can be easily blown away by a small wind also. Just when we walk fast past the puja griham, that light will just blow off, right? Even that can happen. But this deepti, suryasya prakashaha tu, kalpa apaya vayoho api. Kalpa apayam means at the end of pralaya kalam, there is a vayu, there is a strong winds that come during the annihilation, the cosmic destruction, right? So at that point, when that vatena api, esha deeptihi na shamya, it cannot be blown away even by that pralaya kala vatam. How is that pralaya kala vata? Adaya raya, it has a raya vegaha, which is adaya, which doesn't have any daya. Karuna rahita vega yuktaha vayuhu saha. Dalat kshmadharasyapi, it's capable of pulverizing, you know, like dalata means breaking. It is capable of breaking even great mountains. At the pralaya wind, which is capable of breaking down mountains, that cannot blow away this deepti, suryase prakashaha. Next is gada udgirna ujjwala shrihi ahani. Ahani, during the daytime, can this prakasham give any light? See, when it is daytime and you light a lamp outside, it cannot have a beauty at all, because the Surya Prakasha is so brilliant that this small Deepasya Prakashaha will not look so beautiful. So, Parantu Suryasya Prakashaha Gada Udgirna Ujjwala Shrihi Ahani. Ahani, during the day, Suryasya Prakashaha Kathamasti. Gada, it gives out a beauty. It has a beauty. Shrihi, Ujjwala Shrihi, which is resplendent. Prakasha, brilliant beauty, which is Udgirna, which is constantly coming out in thick force. Okay. Which is coming out in thick force. So, Gada Udgirna Ujjwala Shrihi Shri Yukta Deeptihi Tamah Kajjalena Na Rahita Iti Na. Na Rahita Eva. Na Rahita Iti Na Kintu Rahita Eva. Okay. So, Tamah Kajjalena means it doesn't have the suit. So, when a lamp is lighted, there is a black soot that keeps coming out of that lamp. Here he compares it to tamaha, andhakaraha. So andhakara iti kajjalena soot. Rahitaha asti, rahita asti deepihi. Then Surya Prakasha is there is no andhakara. So tamah kajjalena na rahita iti na kintu rahita eva andhakaraha nasti yatra suryasya prakashaha vartati. Next, patangat prapta utpattihi. This is where there is slesha. He actually says sleshopamam vina vyatirekaha. There is a slight slesha here, okay, never mind, let me. But that is not contributing to the beauty of the shlokam. So let me go with that. Patangat prapta utpattihi. Patangaha suryaha. Suryadeva suryasya prakashasya utpattihi bhavati prapta utpattihi esha punaha mosham na upagata. It does not extinguish. It does not get a destruction from, that is it. Because it is born from the surya, it does not get destroyed so easily. Mosham na upagata, or it cannot be stolen. Just like how deepam patangat mosham na prapta utpattihi esha deepa. See, when you look at a normal lamp, when it is lit, a moth can come and fall on it, and because of that moth also it can die, right? Or it can bring about a destruction to the moth also. But generally, the moths can all fly, and the light will not be. If you look at a kerosene lamp outside, if you remember the olden days, then the moth will all come and sit on that lamp, and the prakasham will not be as intense as it normally is. So mosham na upagata, whereas the normal lamp mosham upagachati. Mosham means it, the prakasham it becomes a little bit dim. Whereas the patangadu utpattihi prapta api esha mosham na upagacchati deeptihi. So, Anya Rupa Eva, this one is a very different one. That Anya Rupa is the one that highlights the Vyatirekam here. There is no Upama. You are not comparing the Surya Prakasha to a Deepa Prakasha. You are saying with every step and with every adjective, you are actually saying it is so much better than the Deepa Prakasha. There is only Vyatireka highlighting here. So, Atrahi, Samya Prapancha Pratipadanam Vinayeva, that Upama Alankara is probably Pratiyamanameva. You are trying to compare, but you cannot compare. That's what it comes, right? So, the Vyatirekaha Eva Darshitaha Atra, Samya Prapancha Pratipadanam Vina, without showing the different similarities between a Deepa and Surya Prakasha, he has only brought out the Vyatirekam in this beautiful. Okay. Na atra, the next line is actually connecting it with the Prakritam, which is your Raktastvam. We should not lose the thread of the discussion. Right? So, atra Raktastvam iti shloketu slesha matrat charutva pratitihi asti iti na. It's not only because of slesha that there is a rasaposhakatvam. Correct? In Raktastvam, we go only when we go to that Vyatirekam that we have that Charutvam and we get the Vipralamba Shungaram, right? So, Atra, na Atra Slesha Matrat Charutva Pratitihi Asti Iti Na Raktastvam Navapallavaihi Iti Shloke. It is only because of Slesha that we have a beauty to that Shloka. Iti Na, we cannot say that. Iti Sleshasya Vyatireka Angatvenaiva Vivakshitatvat Na Swataha Alankarata. So, because we need that Vyatireka Alankara to highlight that Vipralamba Shringaram, it is actually Angam. So, he doesn't want to accept that it is a Kaletyagaha and the Purupakshi does not want to accept that there is Samsrishti Alankara. So, it is with the Slesha as an anga, as a subsidiary to Vyatirekam, Vyatireka angatvena iva vyakshitatvat na swataha sleshasya swataha alankarata na asti ityapi na cha vachyam na vachyam. That portion is Siddhanti. Until that is Purupakshi stance. Siddhanti says iti na cha vachyam. No, you cannot say that yataha because एवं विधे विषये साम्यमात्रादपि सुप्रतिपादितात् चारुत्वं दृश्यते एव. Just with just similarity, साम्यमात्रम. There is only, you don't need upama at all. You don't need slesha always. Without slesha and with just upama, vyatirekam can also occur. So why should I always say that Slesha Upama Vyatireka is an Angangi Bhava and there is a Sankara there? That need not be a Sankara there. This is just a Samsrishti Sthala. So Yatha, this is without Slesha, there is Upama and there is Vyatireka. He takes such an example now to say that. Huh? आक्रन्दा स्तनितैः विलोचन जलानि अश्रन्त धाराम्बुभिः तद्विच्छेद भुवः च शोकशिखिनः तुल्याः तडिद्विभ्रमैः अन्तर्मे दयिता मुखं तव शशि वृत्तिः समायेव आवयोः तत्किं माम् अनिशं सखे जलधर त्वं दद्धुमेव उद्यतः. सो विरहि इस् टाकिङ्ग् टु अ मेघ एण्ड् ही सेङ्ग् हे सखे जलधर आक्रन्दाः स्तनितैः आक्रन्दाः विलोचनानि तव स्तनितैः मम आक्रन्दाः समा एव. एव्रिथिङ्ग् दट् वी शेर् आर् ईक्वल् हियर्. ही इस् जस्ट् शोयिङ्ग् ईक्वलिटि नाट् यूसिङ्ग् स्लेश. सो दट् इस् द की पायिण्ट् इन् द श्लोकम्. सो तव स्तनितैः तव गर्जनैः मम आक्रन्दाः. I am crying or I am shouting, polambareng romolyo, you know, that murmuring that we do when we are separated from our lovers. So that is akrandam. So my cryings and your thunder. So both of these are equal. Next is mama vilochana janani, ஐம் கிரைங் கான்ஸ்டன்ட்லி. தவச்ச அஸ்ராந்த தாரா அம்புபிகி, யூ ஆர் கான்ஸ்டன்ட்லி ஷவரிங் ரெயின். சோ அஸ்ராந்த கண்டினியூஸ்லி தாரா அம்புபிகி, யூ ஆர் ஷவரிங் ரெயின் கான்ஸ்டன்ட்லி அண்ட் மை ஐஸ் ஆர் ஆல்சோ டியரிங் அப் கான்ஸ்டன்ட்லி. தீஸ் டூ ஆர் ஆல்சோ ஈக்குவல் டு போத் ஆஃப் அஸ். தெர் இஸ் நோ ஸ்லேஷா ஹியர் அகேன். நெக்ஸ்ட், மே தத் விச்சேத புவஹ ஷோக சிகினஹ, மே தத் விச்சேத புவஹ ஷோக சிகினஹ தவ தடித் விப்ரமைஹி. So, Vicheda Bhuvaha means where, you know, we both were together and suddenly she is no longer with me. So, Naika, that Naika is first with me and then there, like a flash of lightning, she has gone away. Vicheda Bhuvaha means those separation moments, you know, the moments of when I am with her and suddenly she goes away. That moment is called Vicheda Bhuvihi. So the point of separation that I have from her is very similar to shoka shikhinaha tava. You are like you give how do I say that, shoka shikhi means shoka agni. You give me, shikhi is agni, and you give me that grief of fire, you know, that shoka, you give me that grief. And tava shokaha eva shikhi agnihi agni rupaha yaha tvam. So this is an adjective for the jaladhara. So shoka shikinaha tava tadit vibramaihi tulyaha mama vicheda bhuvaha. When you have a flash of lightning and immediately you are also separated from that lightning, in the same manner the lady also shows me her face and then suddenly she is vanishing away. மே அந்தஹா தைதா முகம், ஐ எம் ஆல்வேஸ் சீயிங் ஹர் இன்சைட் ஆஃப் மீ. தவ சசி, யூ பிகாஸ் த கிளவுட்ஸ் ஆர் கவரிங் அப் த மூன். ஸோ தைதா முகம் சசிவ பாசதே மம ஹிருதயே, பட் இட் இஸ் கம்ப்ளீட்லி கவர்டு வித் தட் ஷோகம் தட் இஸ் தேர் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஆஃப் மீ. தட் விரஹேண ஆச்சாதிதா தைதா முகம், லைக் ஹவு இன் மேகசந்தேஷம் ஹி சேஸ் அஸ்ரைஹி விலுப்தம் சங்கமம் நௌ கிருதாந்தஹ க்ரூரஸ் தஸ்மின் அபி ந சஹதே சங்கமம் நௌ கிருதாந்தஹ. When the Yaksha is trying to draw the picture of the lady, he finishes drawing and he wants to draw himself as falling at her feet. And when he wants to draw that, suddenly his eyes become filled with tears when he sees his beloved's picture. And he says, Kruraha, this you know, this Yama is such a cruel person that it does not want us to join even in the picture. And I'm not able to draw myself in that picture. The Daita Mukham Aluptam Bhavati. So it is completely covered in my mind and she's there inside me in the same way, just as how the clouds are covering the moon. Tava Shashi. Iti Avayoho Samayeva Vritti. Both of us are equal there is no slesham in that, right? In every portion it is completely different. Tat anisham mam dagdhumeva tvam kim udyatah. If you think that I am so much superior than you, there is some validity in you trying to hurt me, but you are trying to burn me. Dagdhumeva megham is like an uddipana vibhava for vipralamba shringaram. So the moment you see that Varsha Kalam, you want to be with your beloved and enjoy it, right? But you're showing your face and you want to torture me even further, even though both of us are in the same page. Hey Sakhe, I'm like your friend. No, we both are in the same boat. Tat kim mam anisham, every day mam dagdhumeva. You are coming every day only, you're making an effort. Udyataha bhavati, you're making an effort only to further torture me like this. Ityadav tu slesha rahitena samyena vyatirekah. Oh, next is rasa nirvahanam. Idu pona adu it will be too much. I think we'll stop with this and finish this topic tomorrow. Okay. Any doubts till now? Okay.
No, Akka. So we still have after Kaletya.